recognize the gentleman from Arizona, Mr. Schweikert.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Turner, I appreciate reading over your testimony, but I could really use your help, and I know there's unknowns here. So your number of either fraudulent or mispayments, was that number what I was seeing, $198 billion was the estimate?
191.
Okay, 191. And if the program is about $800 billion, so your number is about 20% of all the payments that went out functionally got tagged in some fashion of either being a mispayment or being fraudulent.
That's correct.
First off, how comfortable are you with that 191, I want to make sure I quote you properly. What's the model in your head or from your researchers that say that number could be more?
Well,
or is it less?
We believe that's the low end, and we believe that number could be more because that does not include the PUA, which dealt with the self-certification the first 9 months.
Okay, you beat me to my punchline, so you see, you take away my shtick. But there's where I want to go. What is their... let's go on the way outside of the tail on the curve.
Okay.
What do they think it could be total?
I have no way of knowing that.
Is
I
know it potentially double?
I have no way of knowing that. The department is planning on putting out the rate for the PUA at the end of the year.
Okay.
And so that will give us a better understanding of what the number may look like.
You see, one of the things that angers me in our hearing right here, and we're all sinners here, is I never want this to happen again. And I wish we would have a much more detailed conversation of, okay, so we see a couple $100 billion mispayments, we believe a substantial number of that is fraud, and the number could be substantially higher than that. How do you do it? At some point, and I'm going to ask from my Inspector General, others, send me a little chart. Send me a booklet. Send me something so I can understand how is the fraud committed. I actually want to understand down to the mechanics. The syndicates that flooded when my wife, who was running a fairly large surgery center in Scottsdale, Arizona, was getting dozens every day of unemployment claims for people who had never worked at her surgery center. It was particularly interesting when she got an unemployment claim for herself when she's running the surgery center. She brought that home and thought that was actually, she wanted me to fix it, and I'm just losing my mind because the numbers of folks we had calling us saying, I'm running a business and I'm getting unemployment claims dramatically more than the number of employees I've ever had. Is that buying data sets off the dark web? Is that the Office of Personnel Management? Data breaches, where did they get the data sets? Did they write bots that automatically kept filling out applications? Then when the checks went out, how did they get people to actually at those addresses collect the checks? How did they convert those checks to cash? How did that cash actually turn into Bitcoin or something else? How did it get offshore? Help us understand the mechanisms and the fraud, because if we're going to stop it, I know we have two things. And forgive me for rambling, a lot of coffee today. I understand much of what we look at. We need a revolution of the data. And this is the data from the IRS to this and that. We need to understand data is actually the solution. But I also want to understand how the criminal network stole billions and billions from our people. I mean, am I asking something? It's too difficult.
No, you're not. Actually, it was a combination of a lot of things you mentioned. But it all mostly starts with stolen identification. When self-certification took place the first 9 months, there was no kind of verification required to say that you deserve those. There was those payments. And that was part of the problem that the IG notified the department about because there, we sent an alert memo out. We also briefed the members.
But Minister, I'm less concerned about the bureaucracy telling this person, telling that person. I right now want to understand the mechanism. If I had my state unemployment offices and we had made it so they had access to commercial data sets, I mean, because commercial data sets out there know what type of ice cream I used to eat and my favorite flavor. How, you know, they have our ability to say, we're going to do red light, green light, bounce off types of data out there, is it our failure to understand the technology that's all around us because we're still promoting archaic systems?
Let me give a better example that would probably help clear this up. So, for instance, stolen Social Security numbers, a lot of times you can buy them on the dark web for 5 cents.
Mm-hmm.
And so a lot of this is multi-state claims that have been filed. In one case, we had an individual file in 42 different states, and they're getting that money back in terms of debit cards. So it's cash to them. And that is hard to kind of keep track of. And so over time, when you start getting organized crime and street gangs involved in this, those numbers multiply.
Mr. Chairman, thank you for your patience with me. I think it would be fascinating, either from Oversight Committee or full committee. I'd love to bring in some of the perpetrators of the crime, you know, who've been convicted. You know, we've done it before. Bring them in, sit them in here, say, tell us how you stole billions of people's money, and we understand what the hell's really going out on in our neighborhoods.